Cam Scott with Terrapin Outfitters. Gonna do a little more hatchling hanging session today. This will be the third take on hanging a hatchling. I'll go through a couple different steps of positioning. Depends on what type of comfort you're looking for. It's already on the cinch buckle. And easy to move up and down as you need to when there's no weight on it. Double-ended stuff sack. I'll show you another benefit of having the double-ended stuff sack for the hatchlings. Put the other one through. Just to go through it again, you're going to go right in the bottom. Right up over the middle part that moves there. This is actually a hybrid model I was working on. Only made the one. I kind of dig it. Up here you have the neon yellow, Moroccan blue, not quite stitched halfway. So if you flip it over, you got a lot of yellow in your back, blue at your bottom, and then we can flip it again. If this was your top, now you could have a little bit of yellow at the bottom or a little bit of blue at the top. Just gives it different amounts. Hadn't put this one into production yet. Been kind of loaded up with our normal ones, the first ones we came out with. We hope to get some made up this summer out on the market, because it gives you a multiple color option without the full weight of a double layer. If you flip it the other way, you're generally sitting on this section, which is doubled. But for now, see how I have it hung up. Head end a little, good bit higher than the foot. Always double check. This is going to give you more of a chair mode. You're just sitting, relaxing. At camp, you're going to have to get up and do stuff, so you don't want to get too comfortable. You know, so you go to sleep. You could go to sleep like this. I actually have, but I sleep everywhere. Lower it a little more, give it more of this angle where they're a little more even. The head is still higher at this point. This is the way I like to sit in them, because I generally sit like this. This gives you a little more comfort, a little more reclining action. Not gonna say comfort, depends on how you like to sit. We have a mod coming to put your feet on here, so you'll be able to rest with your feet up, feet out, which will also help in the picking the right position depending on how you want your feet. Now we can go more straight up, where these are all but at the same height. Now if I had the time, I could really just lay back, relax, take a quick nap, wake up rested, ready to go hike some more, bike some more, kayak some more. Maybe you're out fishing, guessing you don't get real tired fishing. Sun beats on you, that always makes you tired. But in any of these positions, from my favorite, which I was just in, to the more common use is a chair. I hope to see it used more as a go to sleep for a little while. But for now, most of our clients, people that support us in our mission to get people out in nature and vibe with nature and take care of it and have fun in it and enjoy it, most people sit like this. If in this position you are not comfortable, you get a ridge somewhere, you get tension somewhere, that much of an adjustment could make all the difference in the world. That's why they put the ridge lines in the hammocks, so you get the same lay all the time, because it's what works. On these, your body weight affects them. They're small. They're made for lounging for a little while. Hadn't been out in use for that long compared to hammocks. We know how to lay in a hammock. There's no right or wrong way to sit in this unless you're not comfortable. Me, I pretty much can eyeball mine now. I've been hanging it enough. I didn't like where it just was. It made me uncomfortable. So if I went and loosened that back up and undo what I did right there, I know that's where I like it. And that's more comfortable. I know that. You could even mark your straps. But it's micro adjustments make all the difference. Told you I'd get to the benefits of the double-ended stuff sack. If you're out in enjoying your hatchling, the wind's blowing a little bit, you're gonna step away from it, bring the bag down roughly halfway. I guess you could cinch it. That would do even better. You don't have to, but it closes it up, keeps it small, keeps the wind from catching it like a sail, because it will. Just like your hammocks, when the wind blows, your chair will go all over the place. If you put your bag down here, it holds it down, creates a damper, and kind of keeps it still. That's micro adjustments, session 3, hanging the hatchling. We hope you enjoy. Again, cinch buckles work great. There's no pressure on the lines. Put pressure on the lines, they don't give. But you can't loosen them. So never pull the cinch buckles as tight as you can get them between two ends. It'll tighten itself when you sit in it. Hatchlings, something I didn't show you last time. To me, the easiest way to put these back in the bag. I've done it a lot of ways. That is by far the quickest. If you didn't see what I did, I took it off. I simply grab it, go down about halfway, whatever you feel comfortable with. Go again, ball it up, put it right in there, zipped up. If you don't like that method, of course, there's no right or wrong way. The way I used to always do it, the thumb stuff, that works great too. When you're done, it just deploys. I just found this to be a lot nicer. Thank you, Scott from Terrapin Outfitters. Text less, hang more.